I must be just a fitness guru, you know what I
mean?
Yeah, you're
ready for burpee pull-ups, right? You're ready for the cows and the bike then, huh?
What?
Yeah.
How's it going? I'm Sheamus, aka the Celtic Warrior, and welcome to Celtic Warrior Workouts. We're here today in Davenport, Iowa, at Black and Brave Wrestling Academy. And today's episode is actually presented by Wingstop. Wingstop brings flavor to fitness. So please welcome my two very, very special guests, WWE superstars Becky Lynch and Seth Freakin Rollins. How are you doing?
What you got here, fella? We got the snacks. We got
I'm eating all the bleeding food.
Pre-workout.
Vitamin A.
That's vitamin A, actually, isn't it? Carrots.
A treat. Hydration with the celery.
How's eyesight? Vitamin A, right?
Vitamin A.
A? Is there a vitamin A?
I think it's a
vitamin.
Vitamin.
Well, we say vitamins in Ireland.
Vitamin A.
Guys, I really appreciate you being here today. Be honest with you, I'm a little scared because I know how intense you both work out. But obviously, I'm delighted. We're in your backyard.
Yeah, you came to us, man. Thank you.
And today we're going to go through an awesome workout, right? What have we got? What's the name of the workout today?
Oh, it's called Wings, Thighs. Oh, my. It's going to be a blast. You're going to love it. Programmed by the one and only Joshy G, Dead Boys Fitness. We got a whole online fitness catalog ready for the masses, ready for you, ready for the Celtic Warrior workout. It's going to be a blast.
I know you guys ran this channel before. Back in the day, way back when. But things have changed for both of you, right?
You're both
parents now.
We are parents.
Together.
Together, yeah.
One child.
A ma. And a dad.
Yeah.
How has life changed for both of you regarding working out?
Oh, it's quicker. It's a lot quicker.
Really?
It's a lot freaking quicker.
Yeah, faster. You know, you gotta just zip through the things. There's not a lot of dawdling. Less dawdling. You get in, you get out, you move back to the baby. That's how we do it.
So sleep-wise, right? So back obviously when you're both, you know, before you had a child, before you had a baby, like obviously, you know, you could work out whenever you want, stay up as late as you want. How drastically has that changed since you guys have become parents?
I don't sleep anymore.
No?
I mean,
no,
I sleep.
He sleeps.
God bless me.
She's great. Not the world's best sleeper, but she's great, you know? But she's a late sleeper. We got a late schedule, so she's a late sleeper, late riser.
And we have a grandma, and grandmas love their grandbabies. So my mother loves taking care of her grandbaby. So anytime she can take her and have her for the day, she's there right now, as a matter of fact.
That's awesome.
She's all about it. So that allows us the freedom to be able to come in here and do our thing, which we honestly couldn't do it without. So it's a big thank you to Grandma.
So what have we got? What have we got today? What's the crack? For everyone watching, you know what I mean? There's so many people look up to both of you. Now we're training together, married couple, you know what I mean? Little baby, little sprog.
Yeah.
It's a good one, right?
So you're ready for muscle-ups, right?
I'm terrible at muscle ups, but I'm going to do whatever you say.
You love the bike, right? Shamey with the pace. I can't remember the pace is coming back.
All right, enough stalling for me. I'm already dreading this workout, but that's what Celtic Warrior Workouts is all about. Stepping outside our comfort zone and making a brave change. And as you can see, Seth Rollins already eaten the lemon pepper wings. So we better get started before he eats the whole lot. We're going to start with some mango habanero jumping jacks. Because everybody knows, Wingstop brings flavor to fitness. Let's go do a bit. Please eat them all, man. Jesus,
so good.
All right, we're gonna bring flavor to fitness right now with these Wingstop Mango Habanero Jumpin' Jacks. You ready, guys?
Let's go!
Mango habanero.
All right, got the mango habanero jumping jacks out of the way. Now the real workout begins. Seth, Can you tell everyone, explain to everyone at home exactly what we're gonna be doing for this workout?
First little piece of this bad boy is gonna be a 3-rounder. We're gonna do 10 alternating hang dumbbell snatches, which look a little like this. You'll pick your dumbbell up off the ground, start from a hang position, you push the hips back, and you will snatch overhead. You will then switch arms on the way down, and do the opposite. That's two, you'll do 10 of those. Now if you wanna add some flavor.
Ten on each side?
No, five on each side.
Five on each side,
10 total.
Okay.
If you wanna add some flavor to this fitness, you can do the snatch into a squat, which is very, very flavorful. It's 35 pound dumbbell, which is prescribed for men. Feel free to scale your weight if you wanna go down to 5 pounds. If you wanna do no pounds, that's fine too. So you can always just do it with nothing. And then after the 10 reps of that, we're gonna sit back here and do 20 nice and easy sit-ups.
What type of sit-ups are you gonna do? Is it straight knees up or straight down?
I'm doing some butterfly sit-ups. So I'll go like this, right? Touch behind me, touch my toes, get my shoulders across my hips so that it's a full rep, and then back down. Do 20 of these.
20 of them.
3 rounds. So 10 snatches total, alternating arms, and then 20 sit-ups for 3 rounds, and that's the jam.
For the butterfly things.
There you go. Butterfly sit-ups. There you go. Yep. There you go.
What do you do with butterfly? Just question.
So it helps disengage your hip flexors.
Okay.
So if your knees are up like this, one, it stunts your range of motion a little bit. Two, you end up just using your hip flexors to sit up. Whereas if you're like this, your hip flexors get shut off a little bit, and then you're focused more on your abdominal muscles.
You see that?
To crunch up.
This is why we do this channel. Like, for years I've been training, and I've always taught this one here, or the full one, but like, I never ever would have thought of doing butterfly sit-ups.
Yeah.
Like already, every episode, even if it's just one thing you take away from every episode, that's incredible. Like, I'm definitely gonna do that from now on because
it disengages your hip flexors just a little bit so you get a little more focus on your abs.
But never would have thought about that. Something as simple as that. Like,
there
we go. That's the whole point of this channel, you know what I mean? Like, it's even one thing, if you walk away with one thing new, that's kinda just.
No, I'm smiling because you're just so great.
I know, I'm just excited. I appreciate you guys doing this. This is great.
Okay. Kilos.
Me.
Mango habanero.
Land cold brew.
I can feel the flavor flowing through me.
Go on, the fella.
That's it, buddy. That's it.
Killing the game, Shane.
There you go. That's it.
There you go.
Yeah.
Get all the way up there. Get all the way up there.
Touch them toes.
This is when I need to shame you with the pace.
Shame me with the pace. Shame me with the pace. Shame me with the pace.
Shame me with the pace. 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 Shame me with the pace. Pace. Pace.
Shame me with the pace.
Pace. Shame me with the pace.
There you go.
Yeah.
Nice and easy.
Nice and easy.
Easy peasy.
Oh, so easy.
Good little warm up.
Oh, warm up.
If you only feel comfortable doing crunches, only do crunches. If it hurts your lower back to do full sit-ups, don't do full sit-ups. Just do the crunches. Just get that little bit of a burn in there and get through it. And you can also scale the reps too. If 10, 20 is too many for you, or 3 rounds is too many for you, back it up, back it down, take the weight down, whatever you gotta do to make it work for you, because you know, it's all relative. The resistance is relative depending on your current state.
That's great advice. You don't want to jump from 0 to 100, you know what I mean? You want to take your time and build it slowly. Because by doing that, then you'll just deter yourself from doing it. It'll just discourage yourself.
Yeah, don't do that. Should we lift some heavy weights now?
Let's do it.
Let's add some flavor. And by flavor, I mean the barbell.
This is round two. Round two.
Ready to snatch, Bex?
Snatch.
All right.
And then those two.
We're going from a hang again on this one. So very similar to the other movement we did, where we did hang snatches with a dumbbell.
Right.
We're now gonna do, on a running clock, every 2 minutes, 2 reps of a hang squat snatch. So, yeah, so we'll pick it up. We'll grab it, a nice little hook grip, pick it up to our waist like so,
right.
And then we'll go from a hang. So same, almost the exact same position as we did with the dumbbell. We'll bend over, stick our butt back, keep our lats tight, push our knees out a little bit, weight on our heels, and then we'll jump up and get underneath it. And we'll land there, and then we'll come up, bring it back down into our hips, and we'll do another one. And that's it. We'll do that. We'll do two of those every 2 minutes for 5 rounds. So normally you'd work up to a weight that you'd start with, a light weight that you start with, and you can add weight every set and work up to a heavy set. Beginners, please, take it easy on your snatches, please. If you just need a PVC pipe to work on your overhead position, find a PVC pipe. Broom handle, if you're at home and you got a broom, will work just fine. Something easy, because I don't want you to jack your shoulders up. And then find a good coach to help you along with these sorts of things.
We feel by these weight, they're 50 pounds each on each side, you know what I mean? Just because they're smaller doesn't mean they're less light.
But it's all relative, right? He might even be getting a better workout than I am, because the weight for him is relative, right? It's all the difficulty is relative, and that's gonna be that way for anybody picking it up at home as well. It's all relative. What you get out of it is not the weight on the bar. What you get out of it is what you put into it. It's the effort that you put into learning the movement.
Give me that. Put that bleeding gold star on me page, yeah? In me copybook.
There you go. Ugh. Yeah, keep that barbell close. Jump it up. That's pretty good, man. Ugh. You see? You just catch it. That's what I'm talking about, the precision. You just catch it off a little forward to backward, it's going to send you one way or the other. So you got to hit that thing perfect. I love it.
2 grains for Ireland.
Oh.
range of motion.
Savage over here dropping my barbell with tiny weights on it.
What weight is that?
195.
Jesus.
For two. Let's see. Should be.
Oh. Jesus, dude. That's awesome. See? That's why he's able to pick everyone up, no bother, you know what I mean? As well as being able to move around the ring like he's on springs.
Precision, baby. You can also pick people up. Burning lungs here in a minute.
Consistency week after week.
That's accurate.
After week. Yeah, sometimes you don't want to be in here, right? Sometimes you could rather be just sitting at home on the couch. But you know what I mean? You could have come in here. Discipline, routine, what would you call it?
Yeah, consistency works best for me because I think sometimes if you talk about discipline, it almost feels like a chore.
Yeah.
Right? And consistency more feels like you do your best. Because you're not going to, it's just not, you know, life gets in the way. Everything's going to happen where you may not be able to fit it in. But you make time for the things you want to make time for. And I think if you think about it as discipline, sometimes that feels like a
military style.
Yeah, like you're doing something wrong. You're being punished.
Yeah.
Coming to the gym, being fit, even if it's not at the gym, even if it's at home or whatever you're doing, it shouldn't be a chore. It shouldn't be something that you feel like is a punishment for you. It should just be part of your daily routine to help you, you know, be a better human.
No truer word said, no truer, no truer, no truer word said, no truer.
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 Truer. Say it, truer.
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 Yeah, it sounds funny the more you say it.
Truer. Sure. Say tree.
True.
Say 30 tree and a turd.
30 tree and a turd.
There you go.
And a turd? Oh. All right, let's burn the lungs.
Okay, we're two rounds down. We did the dumbbell snatches into squats with some sit-ups. Great style, by the way. I don't call them Hindu, what are they called?
Butterfly.
Butterfly sit-ups. And then we did a couple of snatches. Obviously, the way for me, I have to get my form right, but I feel pretty confident, man. I feel good. I was coming in here going like, I'm gonna get blasted over. I'm gonna be dying, sweat. I'm gonna be gasping for breath, knowing how extreme you two are, you know, with the CrossFit stuff. I don't do CrossFit stuff a lot, but I will pretty much say that I am like, I'm feeling pretty good right now. You know what I mean? I'm like, I'm not blown up. I'm not gasping for breath. I'm strolling through this workout. I feel good, you know what I mean? It's like, Jamie's back! Like, Jamie's like, you know, like, listen, I shortchanged myself a couple of times, but man, I must be just a fitness guru, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah,
fitness guru. You know what I mean?
Yeah! Yeah! Yeah. See CrossFit. So you're ready for burpee pull-ups, right? You're ready for the cows on the bike then, huh? We're good. You think you're ready?
What?
Yeah. Yeah. I just, you know, easy. Guru, fitness guru, king of CrossFit. Yeah, there we go. Bike, baby, here we go. Last round, the finisher. You ready for it?
Easy peasy.
10 cows on the bike, 1 burpee pull up. 10 cows on the bike, 3 burpee pull ups. 10 cows on the bike, 5 burpee pull ups. 10 cows on the bike, 7 burpee pull ups. Easy.
Fine, so you're saying 1 burpee, 3 burpees, 5 burpees, 7?
That's it, yep. That's
on the bike? Easy. Just riding the bike?
Easy, that's it. And then we do the cows on the bike. You just pump it till it reads 1, and then 2, and then 3, all the way to 10. We'll reset the bike and we'll do that every time. Easy. 4 rounds, low numbers, 10, 1, 2, 1, 3, 5, 7. Easy. No problem, right?
I'm not bothered me, man. I'm, you know, top of my game right now.
Yeah. There we go. I love it. It's going to be a, what do they call it, a banger?
It's going to be a banger, yeah.
It's going to be a banger.
All right, easy peasy, right? Yeah. Let's go do it. Jump on the bike.
Last set.
Best set. You guys ready?
I'm ready.
All right, ready. Count it down from 10.
Here we go.
10 seconds.
Don't break.
Okay, here we go.
Fell on the ground. Lungs on fire. Ooh-wee. Thought he was gonna get me. I did. Thought he was gonna get me. But I got that ass.
Lungs on fire.
Yeah. Yeah, you did great, too.
Did great.
Yeah.
Did great.
He went out
way too hot. Way too hot.
Oh, but no, really. My lungs are.
Yeah.
It's the cold air. Could be the cold air.
It is the cold air.
Yeah, I mean,
gets in the throat.
Also, you went out too hard.
You went out very hard.
But such a simple workout like that, a combo, unbelievable for your fitness.
Nasty.
I love the way you just dragged me to some false sense of security and just killed me at the end.
I mean, look.
You went out so hot, man. You beat me.
You did go hot.
I
expected you to collapse earlier.
Yeah, me too.
You know why though? Because I knew if I did stop, I wouldn't be able to get back up.
That's fair.
So I was there just
good,
going.
Good call.
I just kept going until I just couldn't go anymore. Because if any of I'd stopped, there ain't no way I was going to get back up. I had this momentum getting me going.
That's the beauty of this type of programming is that it really focuses on being good at everything. So that's what we try to do today is focus on everything. You had speed, agility, you had power, you had strength, you had some gymnastics, you had all that good stuff, endurance. Because, got the lungs going.
You feel it too?
Yeah, it's terrible.
Yeah, the coldness, you know?
Being in the cold air.
But great stuff. You did really good. I thought you were going to collapse around five, but we got off the bike about the same time, back on the bike about the same time, after the third round or second round, and then it was just a foot race to the end. I knew I'd get you.
How long is that? My chest is on fire.
Chest? Oh, yeah.
That was a fun one. Thanks again for watching. And thanks to Becky and Seth for pretty much killing me on the bike and those burpee pull-ups. I don't think I'm ever gonna speak the same again. This episode has been brought to you by Wingstop. Head to Wingstop today.
With veggie sticks.
Wingstop helps get your gains while keeping on track with your fitness goals.
And don't forget my favorite flavor, lemon pepper dry rub.
Tasty, right? Mm. I've been waiting all day for this.
No.
I see where Rue gets it from. I ain't even more.